Links for that also is given in the description. Now let us see the rules for the rules are simple. Pause the question when it appears on your screen and try to answer. There are 2 marks for the correct answers. I have avoided negative marking, and friends, this exam is of 100 marks. If you are getting 80 and above, you are outstanding. All you need is simple revision. If you are getting 60 and above, then your score is good, but you need to work a little on your topics which you are lagging behind. And if your score is 40 and above, then you have to bring it to 60. Because that is a minimum requirement. I'm saying it minimum because that will take the load out of your subject. You don't have to score more on your subject. If your score in paper 1 is good, you can have that luxury of scoring less in your subject. Otherwise, if your score is 40 in your teaching aptitude paper, you have to score more in subject paper. So friends, moving on to the first question. If a majority of students in your class are weak, you should. The options are not care about the intelligent student, keep your speed of teaching fast so that student comprehension level may increase, C, keep your teaching slow. Keep your teaching slow along with some extra guidance to the bright pupils. So friends, when your majority of your students are weak, you will teach slowly with some extra care for the bright pupils. So friends, the correct answer is keep your teaching slow along with some extra guidance to the bright pupils. Hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the second question. So second question is, a teacher who is not able to draw the attention of his students should. Options are A, evaluate his teaching method and improve upon it, B, resign from the post, C, find the fault in his pupils, and D, start dictating. So friends, the correct answer for a teacher who is not able to draw attention of his student should be he should evaluate his own self and try to find out shortcomings and then improve upon it. So the correct answer is evaluate his teaching method and improve upon it. Moving on to the third question. If some of your pupils misbehave with you in the college campus, you must. Now friends, options are the report to the principal, report to the parents, C, improve their behavior by your own character and scholarship, and D, mobilize other teacher against the guys. So friends, the good teacher is example by his own character. So the correct answer is improve their behavior by his own character and scholarship. So friends, you may ask like why not report to the principal, why not report to the parent. So these are, you cannot as a teacher, you cannot go for the drastic solutions. See, if you go to the principal, there may be a harsh action on the students. So here as a teacher, you should be a moderate, and your action should not be harsh. So your aim should be to correct the students and not to destroy their future or to act in a such a way that which will be harmful or which will be detrimental to their progress. So the correct answer is you will try to improve their behavior by your own character. Okay, now moving on to the next question. If a backbenchers are always talking in the classroom, a teacher should. So options are A, let them do what they are doing, B, punish them, see, ask them to sit on the front bench, and none of the above. So friends, these teaching aptitude questions, you may find 3-4 out of 3-4 two answers correct, but among the answers, you have to find the correct answers, the best possible option that you have to choose. So you may argue that this option A is correct, option B is correct, or option C is, but you should give the most probable answer. So the most probable answer in this question is you can simply ask them to sit on the front benches. We have seen the student when he's on the front bench, like it is most of the student don't talk when they are on the front bench. So the correct answer is C, ask them to sit on the front bench. Moving on to the fifth question, listening to a lecture. So friends, listening to the lecture is a information listening. So types of listenings are there. So listening to the lecture is information listening. Now moving on to the next question. Teaching on TV is superior to the classroom instruction because, now friends, you, some of you may argue that the classroom instruction is better than the TV. So friends, that may be the case, but here you have given a situation that TV is a superior to the classroom in what ways. Now option A is very large classes are made possible and thus it is economically advantageous. This is correct because when you know the, even take an example of YouTube, if I am teaching a class, hardly I can teach 50 or 100 people, but this video, based on, you can see the views, there may be 1000 views, sometimes 10,000 views, sometimes lakhs views. So only a simple video is reaching to the lakhs of students, so it is economically advantageous. Now B, experts from the teaching a difficult topic can be arranged and others can be benefited from them. So friends, this is also an correct answer, as for TV teaching you don't have to go to the classroom. If someone is sitting in their office in Delhi, he can teach to the students of Chennai. Someone is sitting in Delhi, Chennai, and he can also teach to the students of Delhi. So this is correct. Teaching material can be filmed for reuse. So this is also correct. You can reuse this material because it is already recorded. So the correct answer is all of these. So the correct answer for this question is all of these. Now moving on to the seventh question. Listening is badly affected by message overload, excess of listened material, high speed of speaking. Yeah, this is correct. A sizable hearing loss, physiological problem. This is also correct. So the correct answer is all of the above. Eighth question is, which of the following method of the communication is the most effective? So friends, they have asked the most effective method of the communication. The options are presenting the written material, B, presenting the written material along with film projector, and C, multimedia method and cannot be determined. So the friends, among these, the C is the C, that is multimedia method. Multimedia, like you can have PowerPoint, you can have videos and different graphics. So this is the most effective method of the teaching. So friends, I hope you have answered it correctly. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is the most important single factor in underlying the success of beginning as a teacher? So the friend, the correct answer for this is, of the four options, is the personality and its ability to relate to the class and to the pupils. So I hope you have answered it correctly. Moving on to the next question. Now these questions are from the higher education system, and they have asked with reference to higher education system, UGC stands for. So UGC, as we all know, it stands for University Grant Commission. With reference to institutes in higher education, NCRI stands for. So friends, this is important because this is somewhat out of this thing question, because national, now let's see what are the options. Options is National Council of Rural Institute, National Committee of Rural Institute, and National Council of Research Institute, and D, none. So generally we tend to go for research, but this is not National Council of Research Institute. It is National Council of Rural Institute, and its headquarters is in Hyderabad. So correct option is A, National Council of Rural Institute. Now moving on to the next question. With reference to institute in higher education, ICHR stands for. The option A is Indian Committee of Historical Research, B, International Council of Historical Research, C, Indian Council of Historical Research, and D is Indian Council of Human Research. So friends, this is the correct option for ICHR is Indian Council of Historical Research. So the correct option is C. Hope you have guessed it correctly. Now moving on to the next question. With reference to institute in higher education, ICPR stands for Indian Council of Philosophical Research, Indian Council of Physiological Research, International Council of Philosophical Research, and D, International Council of Physiological Research. So correct option, friends, for this is A, Indian Council of Philosophical Research. Now moving on to the next question. With reference to Institute in Higher Education, ICSSR stands for Indian Council of Space Science and Research, B, International Council of Social Science and Research, C, Indian Council of Social Science and Research, and D, International Council of Space Science and Research. So friends, correct answer for this is Indian Council of Social Science and Research. That is option C is the correct option for this. The 15th question is, with reference to publication of book, ISBN stands for. So friend, ISBN, as you have seen, you might have seen on the back of the book, there will be one ISBN number. So this ISBN number is an international standard book number. With reference to the publication of book, NBT stands for. So as we have seen in the last question, the ISBN is international book number, but an Indian agency which maintains the books are, see, this is National Book Trust. NBT stands for what? NBT stands for National Book Trust. This also is a B option. Now moving on to the next question. With reference to Autonomous Organizations of Government of India, CSIR stand for. So option A is Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. Option B is Committee of Scientific and Industrial Research. Option C is Council of Space and Industrial Research. Option D is Committee of Space and Industrial Research. So CSIR, friends, stands for Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. So it is Autonomous R&D Organization of Government of India. The correct answer is A, Council of Scientific and Industrial Research. Now moving on to the next question. With reference to Autonomous Organization of Government of India, is NCERT stands for. So friend, NCERT devises the curriculum for CBSE and other boards. Now the long form of NCERT is National Council of Educational Research and Training. So the correct option is National Council of Educational Research and Training. I hope you have guessed it correctly. A is the correct answer, not other B, C, D are not the correct answer. It is not teaching, it is training only. So correct answer is A. Now moving on to the next question. With reference to Autonomous Organization of Government of India, KVS stands for. So the KVS, friends, stands for what? It stands for option A, that is Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. Remember, friends, it stands for Kendriya Vidyalaya Sangathan. The correct answer is answer A, option A. Okay, friends, moving on to the next question for the. And the 20th question is, with reference to computer network, WAN, WAN stands for. So, friends, this question is from Information and Communication Technology. And the correct answer for the WAN, it stands for Wide Area Network. It is Wide Area Network is a telecommunication network or computer network that extends over a large geographical area. This large geographical area can be a global area or a national area or a state area. So this is Wide Area Network. Now next question, with reference to computer network, LAN stands for. So LAN stands for option A is Local Administrative Network, Local Area Network, C, Logical Administrative Network, D, Logical Area Network. So the correct answer for this question is Local Area Network. So friends, what is LAN? It is Local Area Network is a computer network that interconnects computer within a limited area, such as residence, school, laboratory, university campus or office building. Please remember the difference between the local area network and wide area network. Now the next question for today is, with reference to computer network, PAN, P-A-N stands for personal. Option A is Personal Administrative Network. Option B is Personal Area Network. Option C is People's Administrative Network. Option D is People's Area Network. So the correct answer for this MCQ is Personal Area Network. So friends, Personal Area Network
is a computer network used for data transmission. Remember this, personal area network is used for data transmission. So among the devices such as computers, telephones, tablet and personal digital assistant. So friend, the simple example of personal area network is a Bluetooth. Bluetooth from your phone you can send data to the other phones. That is, and range, you see range is very limited in personal area network. Hope you have cleared. Now next question. With reference to computer area network, MAN, M-A-N stands for Middle Administrative Network, Metropolitan Area Network, Metropolitan Administrative Network, Middle Area Network. So friend, the correct answer for this MAN is Metropolitan Area Network. So the Metropolitan Area Network is a computer network that interconnects user with computer resources in geographic area region larger than that covered by the LAN and smaller than that of wide area network. So friends, remember this very important difference. It is larger than LAN and smaller than WAN, that is wide area network. So this will be helpful for you.
24th question is, with reference to computer network, CAN, CAN stands for. So friends, the CAN stands for Campus Area Network. Remember this, different types of network like CAN, LAN, WAN and MAN. So these are the different types of network. One question, there is a probability or there is a possibility of one question from this area networks is. Now moving on to the 25th question. So they have asked the long form of the UNEP. So this is from the People and Environment. 25th question I have taken from the People and Environment. And the correct answer for this UNEP long form is United Nations Environmental Program. So friend, I hope you have answered it correctly. And this is the further reading. The United Nations Environment Program is an agency of United Nations and coordinates in its environmental activities, assisting developing countries in implementing environmentally sound policies and practices. Moving on to the next question. With reference to Environmental Protection Agency, SACEP stands for option A, South Africa Cooperative Environment Program, option B, South Asia Cooperative Environment Program, option C, South Asia Cooperative Environment Plan, option D, South Africa Cooperative Environment Plan. So the correct answer for this is B, South Asia Cooperative Environment Program. So you can read it here. South Asia Cooperative Environment Program is founded in 1982 by South Asian governments to promote the environment in the region. Now moving on to the next question. With reference to Environment Protection Agency, UNCED stands for. So option A is United Nations Committee on Environment and Development. Option B, United Nations Committee on Earth and Development. Option C, United Nations Conference on Earth and Development. And option D is United Nations Conference on Environment and Development. So the friends, correct answer for this question is D, United Nations Conference on Environment and Development. So the United Nations Conference on Environment and Development is also known as Rio de Janeiro Earth Summit, the Rio Summit, the Rio Conference, and the Earth Summit. And it was a major United Nations conference held in Rio de Janeiro from 3rd to 14th June 1992. So friends, remember UNCED. Now moving on to the next question. With reference to Environmental Protection Agency, GEF stands for Group Environment Facility, option B, Green Environment Facility, C, Ground Environment Facility, D, Global Environment Facility. So the correct answer for this question is Global Environment Facility. The Global Environment Facility was established on the eve of 1992, that Rio Janeiro Summit. Now friends, moving on to the next question. With reference to Environmental Protection Agency, FSI stands for Forest Survey of India, First Survey of India, Fisheries Survey of India, and Fire Survey of India. So the correct answer for this question is Forest Survey of India. So friends, Forest Survey of India is Indian organization under Ministry of Environment and Forest, Government of India, and its principal mandate is to conduct
survey and assessment of forest resources in our country. So friends, this was it for today's lecture. I hope you have liked it. If you have liked it, please subscribe to Global London University. Thank you.
The 13th question is, what is the main purpose of punishment to the students? So the friends, the main purpose of punishment to the students or to anyone for that matter is to reform the offender. So the correct answer for this question is to reform the offender. Next question. Dash dash is the quality of a good teacher. Now, to control over the emotions, good command over the subject, physical strength and sense of humor. So the correct answer is good command over the subject. If a teacher has good command over subject, he will teach it fluently, he will teach it with confidence. If you don't have command over subject, then everything else is useless. Now the correct answer here is the good command over the subject. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the third question. On which list the education is in the Indian Constitution? So there you, as you know, there are three lists of the subject, where central list is dealt exclusively by center, and state list is dealt exclusively by state, and concurrent list is a list where you have both state and center have almost equal say, with say center having an upper hand. Now the education is placed in the concurrent list of the constitution. So friend, remember this. So this is memory based question. You have to remember that education is in concurrent list of the Indian constitution. Now moving on to the next question. You want to ensure participation of more students in the class. Which of the following method of teaching would you adopt? So for participation of more students, what one has to do, it not a recitation will not, it will not be a participation, demonstration also will not be, you will not have more participation. When you have discussion, you will have more participation of the students. Student can exchange their views amongst themselves with you. You can exchange your views with students. So this way, the more participation, the more students will participate. So discussion is the way to increase the participation. Remember this, hope you have answered it correctly. Now moving on to the next question. So next question is, to make learning effective, a goal must be meaningful in terms of option is A, objective of the curriculum, B, intellectual ideas, C, standards of others. So C can be eliminated because standards of others cannot make the learning effective. If you have standards of other is a goal, then you cannot make it. Now intellectual ideas is, it is for a research. If you want a research effective, you should have more intellectual ideas. So that also cannot be can be eliminated. Now objective of the curriculum and the needs and purpose of the student. So these are the two options I am one can think of. Now if you have objective of the curriculum in your mind, so there your aim, if you, that is your goal, then it will be a narrow thinking. You will not move out of your objective of the curriculum. The correct answer for this is the need and purpose of the students. So you should understand the need and the purpose of students for making learning effective. You cannot teach a hard, or you cannot teach the advanced level things to the grade 1 or grade 5 students. So based on their grade, based on their ability, their needs, and what is the purpose, what is the output you are expecting, based on that you have to, if that is your goal, then learning will be effective. So the correct answer is the need and purpose of the student. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following items of the information are important for important about student to motivate them for studies? So to motivate them for studies, the learning style is important, to personality of individual is important, socio-cultural background of every student will be different, that is also important. So the correct answer is all of the above. So the the important information is learning style, personality, social cultural background. Now moving on to the next question. If you want to improve the ability to observe, so observation ability in students, if you want to increase, what is, which of the following would you recommend? So here, generating interest is the subject, developing the framework for experience, sharpening the senses, and D, training mental faculties. So here it is also a memory based question. What the answer for this is, training mental faculties. So mental faculties are the memory, observation, perception, reasoning, will, judgment. So if you train all those things,
then the ability to observe among the children will increase. So remember that mental faculties are memory, observation, perception, reasoning, will, judgment. Now moving on to the next question, which is you want to develop cooperation and team spirit in student. Which activity would you propose? So the four activities are art, debate, project work and quiz. So friend, these four activity here, art is, it can be individual or it can be in the team, but this is eliminated. Now three out of three, debate, project work and quiz, the project work appears to be the correct answer, as here you will have different tasks, and when you have different tasks you have to have cooperation between them to carry out those tasks. So the correct answer is project work. Now moving on to the
38th question is, what is the purpose of research aptitude paper for candidates of UGC NET set? So friends, the purpose is to identify and the screen candidate with scientific approach. So anyway, any screening agency will screen and they will identify the candidate based on the criteria that is required for that particular profession. So here it is to identify and screen the candidates with the scientific approach.
Next question is, field study in the research is related to. So friends, when field study is something which is related to the real life situations, so generally researcher go into the whatever research he is doing into the real life situations, where he can, if his research is about economics, I'm giving the general examination, he goes in the market and study it for say some specific period. Now that is the field study. You go in the, it is not something which is done in the laboratory or not in the some experimental condition. So it is the real life situation. So field study, remember this, field study is about the real life situations. Now moving on to the next
40th question is, what is the synopsis of a research paper? So friend, synopsis, the term similar to synopsis are summary, abstract. So you can clearly see that it is a summary of finding of the research. So whenever you see synopsis, you relate it to summary and the abstract. Oh, I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question.
Which of the following proposition is not true about the research? So friend, this is interesting question which I have included. It improves the quality of teaching. So friends, it is proved that there is no relation between the researcher being a good researcher and he can be a good teacher. He may be a bad researcher, but he can be a good teacher. So there is no relation. Option A is ruled out. Now, if it leads to finding of solutions. So friends, thing is, like when you do research, you will understand that it's not about finding the solutions. Not every time, almost 99% you end up nowhere in the research. So it is not true here. Only 1 or 2% people will find some solution, but 98% about like there is nothing. You cannot like do a very path breaking research or something. Now that also is ruled out. Now the option D, it contributes to the social progress of the country. Now see, research as such is helpful. The data generated by research is helpful in the in implementing the schemes, but it is not directly contributing to the social progress of the country. Now the correct answer for this, if you are a researcher, you will understand, it is joyful. It is not a true statement. Research is very painstaking. You have to really give your lot of time and you have to really work very hard, which is not really joyful. Sometimes you feel like you should leave the research. So and more often you don't enjoy it when it like it becomes painstaking, but there is a joy of finding that comes after you get results, but it is not joyful when you start from the beginning. So the not true about research is, it is a joyful. So it is not joyful, it is a painstaking, but there is some, like when you have inspiration, you go on doing research. So the not true about research is, it is joyful. Moving on to the next question, which of the following are the qualities of good researcher? So friends, it is this is a very important question. First is, he picks up vast area and tries to understand the minute details. So this is not, you when you are doing research, you have to find a very specific area. So you remember, whenever a researcher works,
you should the general guideline is you should pick the specific problem and not the vast problem. See, when you pick a vast problem, there are a lot of things which can be done, but for a particular researcher to cover all those things, it is almost equal to impossible. So here we can option A and C can be limited as she picks up vast area, that is not possible. Now picks up the specific area and tries to understand the basic detail. So this is not correct here. So she cannot pick the specific area and understand the basic detail, then there will be no research. Now she picks up the specific area and tries to understand the every minute detail of that area. So that is a quality of a good researcher. So friends, I hope this is clear to you. If there is some doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Now moving to the next question. The example of scientific knowledge is, so option is authority of prophet or a great man. So this cannot be a scientific knowledge. It is, say, it cannot be trusted because there is no experimentation. Social tradition and customs, these are also not based on the scientific this thing. Now religious scriptures are also not scientific, because see, what is the scientific knowledge? What we call scientific knowledge, which can be reproduced and which is reliable. So what is that thing? The laboratory and field experiment which can be reproduced. If I say something, there should be some proof. So someone like say, if I say something, a person has to for proving me wrong, he has to do some experiment, and if he proves me wrong, then it can be like, okay, this is not a scientific knowledge, it is some fake thing. But when I am saying something which is reproduced and reproduced by many, then it is a scientific knowledge. So that can be done only in laboratory and field experiment. All other options are not true here. So the correct answer is the laboratory and field experiments. Moving on to the next question. A researcher selects only 10 members as a sample from the total population of 5000 and consider it good because. So this is the question from the sampling. So friends, remember, when sample size is low, all you need, it should be a homogeneous. When what is mean by homogeneous? When I am from a school, if I have to take a sample of the students, so what will I do when I take some from 5th grade, some from 10th grade? So there will be a lot of age difference, so that will not be the correct homogeneous size. From school of say 1 lakh students, if I take only from the 5th class, which has 5000 students, so their age, their all the thinking and everything will be same. So if I take from the 5th class 10 people, that is the homogeneous sample for me. So for a researcher, now this answer to this will be the population should be homogeneous. So remember this, when you are taking a small sample, it should be homogeneous. So now moving on to the next question. A bibliography given in a research report. So option A is helps those interested in further research and studying the problem from another angle and makes the report authentic. Option C is both A and C, and D is none of the above. So the bibliography, friends, what is it? Like I'm giving a simple this thing. When someone writes an article, or say for that matter a paragraph, a simple paragraph, if I write something that can be just a hypothetical thing that just came out of me and I wrote, and there is no reference given to it. So what is bibliography? It is a references given to the paragraph I wrote. If someone is interested and do further research, there is nothing, there is no bibliography, so that cannot be considered as authentic. So if you bibliograph it, when you reference it, you give references, so it can be, it will help those who are interested to further research, to cross check those references which I have given. And one more thing is, when there is a reference, you are actually referring them which is already reported, so it makes your report authentic. So these are the things. So the correct answer here is both A and B, that is C, option C. Question is, UGC was formally established by an act of parliament in the year. Option A is 1961, option B is 1956, option C is 1950, and option D is 1953. So friends, this is memory based question,
and you should know that UGC was established by an act of parliament in 1956. Let us know more about UGC. So UGC, as I said, was established by act of parliament in 1956, and it comes under the Ministry of Human Resources and Development, and its functions are coordination, determination and maintenance of standards of higher education in India, and it provides the recognition to the university, and it also takes care of the funds to such a recognized universities and colleges. And one more important thing, its headquarter is in Delhi, and it has 6 regional centers in Pune, Bhopal, Kolkata, Hyderabad, Guwahati and Bangalore. So friends, remember these points. Question may be asked on any of these points. The question which I asked was on the when was it established, but they may also ask its headquarter, where is its headquarter, or they may also ask what are its function, and they may also ask you which ministry the UGC comes under. So you can prepare accordingly. Now next question is, which of the following statements are correct about deemed university? So friends, deemed university are also called private universities. Now the option A is they are established by central government. Option B is they are established by state government. Option C is they can design their own syllabus and course. And D, none of the above. So friends, option A is they are established by central government. When it is established by central government, they are called central universities, like University of Hyderabad, like DU, Delhi universities, like JNU. So these are the central universities. And when they are established by state governments, they are called state universities. So state universities, like there are many states universities, like Kolhapur, Shivaji University, like you can have your whichever state you are residing, there are many states universities, they are established by the state government. Now the deemed university, they have this autonomy of having their own syllabus, having their own coursework. In the next slide I'll tell you more about the deemed university. Now the correct answer is they can design their own syllabus and course. So they are not established by state or center, they are established by either private entities or say businessmen or say NGOs. And now moving on to the we'll see detail about the deemed university. So let us know it. The central universities or the union universities are established by act of parliament, and they are under the Department of Higher Education. Now state universities, as I said, they are established by act of local legislative assembly. So and there, see, in case of central universities they are funded by center, and in case of state universities they are funded by state. And private universities or deemed university, as I said, they are funded by the private people. Private in the sense they may be NGO, there may be a private businessman or whoever, but for that they are approved by UGC and they can grant degrees. So these are their functions. They can grant their own degrees, and but they are not allowed to have off campus colleges. So this is the thing about the private or deemed university. And so the more functions which private or deemed university is that they can design their own syllabus and coursework, they can frame their own guidelines regarding the admission and fees, and they can also grant degrees. So friends, remember these things about deemed universities, central university and state universities, because anything, like any question can be asked, like any, they can tune it in other way, who establishes the state universities or what are their autonomy. And one more thing, in case of state universities, the governor of the state is the vice chancellor, and in case of state central universities, the president is the vice chancellor. So remember these things. And in case of the deemed university, the governor is not a vice chancellor, they have their appointed vice chancellor. This is one major difference that you should remember. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following statement is correct about the NAC? So what is NAC? Is National Assessment and Accreditation Council. So option A is it is an autonomous institution. Option B is it is tasked with the responsibility of distributing funds to colleges. And option C is it is located in Delhi. And option D is it has regional offices. So friends, NAC is not, it does not have any responsibility of distributing the funds. As we studied earlier, UGC has the responsibility of distributing the funds. So option B is eliminated, and its headquarter is located in Bangalore and not in Delhi. Remember this. And it has regional offices, so it doesn't have any regional office. It has only one office, that is in Bangalore. So only one option, that is, it is an autonomous institute. It is correct, and it is under the UGC. Now let us know more about the NAC. So NAC is an organization that helps in assessing and accreditation of the higher education institution in India, and it is an autonomous body funded by UGC, and its headquarter is in Bangalore. So friends, these are the points that you should remember in case of NAC. So there will be question on either UGC, NAC or the other bodies of the government. Now friends, moving on to the next question. Prime Minister's Research Fellowship is for students pursuing PhD program in. So friends, last year in the year 2018, our Prime Minister Shri Narendra Modi ji has launched this PMRF Fellowship. So generally they said that while in the notification it was said that there will be 1,000 PhD fellowships. And what is the important thing about this PMRF Fellowship? It is that fellowship amount is a little higher or more than what generally we get for doing PhD in India. Generally people get around 28 or 25,000 per month. But in this fellowship, the research scholar would he will get 70,000 for first 2 years, and then it will increase to 85,000 or something for the next 3 years for his PhD. So this PMRF was launched, but sadly the when they notified it was 1,000 fellowships, but the actual result came and there were only 150 candidates selected. But now knowing going to the question, Prime Minister Research Fellowship is for student pursuing PhD program in which state and central university, be central university, IISc, IIT, NIT, IISER, IITs, and option C is IISc, IITs, NITs, IISERs, IITs, state and central universities, and D is IITs and IISc. So friends, the correct answer to this is, now they have also included the central universities after one, and IISERs. Yeah, after one more modification to the rule. So the state university is ruled out. They have not included the state universities for the PMRF fellowship. So remember this, the state universities are not in the list where you can take this PMRF fellowship. So the correct answer for this is option B, central university, IISc, IIT, NITs, IISERs and IITs. So friends, this was it in today's lecture. If you have liked it and if you have some suggestions, please post it in comment section. And if you have liked it, please share, like, comment or nation. Now going on to the first question. So the first question is, the National Council of Educational Research and Training, that is NCERT, was established in. So friends, generally this paper 1 will ask the year of the establishment of the various autonomous government organization. So the correct answer for this is, it was
NCERT was established in 1961. I hope you have answered this question correctly. The second question is, Navodaya schools have been established too. So here they have asked the motive or the aim of establishing the Navodaya schools. So friends, Navodaya schools are established keeping in mind the rural areas, so to provide good quality education in the rural areas. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Now moving on to the third question. As a principal, how would you behave with below average students? So friend, as you can see from the options, for below average student you need to be generous. Generous meaning or generous to me is you have to give them extra attention. They may not catch up what you are saying. You don't have to get angry with that. You have to put a little extra efforts to make them understand. So that way you have to be generous. So this is the answer, that you should be a generous towards the below average students. Now moving on to the fourth question. The fourth question is, what is the most important while writing on the blackboard? So friend, good handwriting is like, it is a gift. Not everyone will have the good handwriting. Some of us will have good handwriting, but all of them cannot be a teacher. So everybody with whatever handwriting can be the teacher. So the B is ruled out here. The correct answer for this is, there should be a clarity in your writing. So whatever you are writing, whether good or bad, it should be readable to the everyone. So the correct answer for this question is, it should be clear to everyone. So the clarity in the writing is the correct answer. Now moving on to the fifth question. Education is powerful instrument of. So let us see options. A, social transformation. Yes, it is a powerful instrument of the social transformation. B, personal transformation. Yes, if you are educated, there is certainly a personal transformation. Now cultural transformation also takes place with the education. So friends, so the correct answer for the this question is all of the above. Education is powerful instrument of the all of the above options. Now moving on to the sixth question. Research problem is selected from the standpoint of. So friends, if you have seen the research problem selection, so friends, the major and most important factor is researcher's interest. Why it is major important? Because see, you may have financial support, you may have availability of relevant literature, and you may you may find it socially relevant. But friends, if there is no interest, it is impossible to do a good research. It is importance, researcher's interest is the prime, or it is the primary criteria for selecting the research problem. If say I am not interested in some topic, but everything else is available, and if I do that research, after 6 months or after a year, I'll get bored, and I there will not be a fruitful outcome. So the correct answer is researcher's interest. Moving on to the seventh question. How does a teacher can improve the attention of his students by introducing the interesting ways of teaching? So the by option, correct answer for this is, I hope you have read the four options, is by introducing interesting ways of teaching through teaching aid. So this is the correct answer, by introducing the teaching aid. Now the eighth question is, curriculum is. So friends, we often come across in higher education system this word curriculum. So the curriculum refers to overall activities of an institution. So curriculums has all the syllabus. It has it is a detailed timetable of the particular course. So remember this thing, it is overall activities of an institution. And moving on, ninth question is, how would you make your students independent? So friends, if you have to make someone independent, you should give him a responsibility. Unless and until a responsibility is inferred on the individual, he won't become responsible. So the correct answer for this, to make student independent, one should give them responsibility to everyone. So everyone here refers to the students. So moving on to the next question. 10th question is, the internal communication within the institution is done through. So friends, it is done through LAN, that is local area network. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the 11th question. WWW stands for. So friends, it is an easy question, but it is good to revise because it stands for World Wide Web. That is option C. Now moving on to the 12th question. A gigabyte is equal to, so friends, gigabyte, that is GB. 1 GB is equal to, we all use mobile and there is a data. So 1 GB is equal to 1024 megabyte. So friends, I hope you have followed it. And 1024 kilobytes is equal to 1 megabyte. And 1024 bytes is equal to 1 kilobyte. So remember this convergence and remember this memory unit, because generally from communication or say from ICT, information and communication technology, there are questions on memory size and memory relation. So you have to remember this. Moving on to the 13th question. A computer virus is, so friends, computer virus is a malicious software designed to infect your computer or infect some of your computer programs. So they are software. Remember this, computer virus is not a bacteria, hardware or anything else. It is a software designed to infect your computer. Now moving on to the next question, which is the file extension of MS Word document in Office 2007 is. So friends, remember this file extension because there will be a sure shot question on the different file extension, popular file extension. And for the extension for MS Word document in Office 2007 is .docx. So friends, remember this, the document in Office 2007, the file extension is .docx. Now moving on to the 15th question, which of the following operating system used on mobile? So friend, we know iOS system is used for Apple mobile, so that option is not here. Now generally in India, apart from Apple, what operating system is used in our mobile is Android operating system. So Windows XP and Windows Vista are used for the laptops. So remember this, the correct answer for operating system on mobile is Android. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is different from the other member? So they have asked you to take out the odd member. Now friend, if you see Windows, Linux and Mac, so these are operating system. So whereas option A, Google, which is a search engine. So remember this, Google is a search engine, Windows, Linux and Mac are operating system. So the odd members here is Google. Now moving on to the 17th question. Computers on and internet are identified by. So friends, they are not identified by email. Email is for individual. So you can open in one email in other any laptop or any desktop or any mobile, but the IP address for computer is a unique ID. So their address or they are identified by IP address. Now moving on to the 18th question. CD-ROM stands for. So this is a factual question and the answer for this is compact disc read only memory. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the 19th question. It is GIF, JPG, BMP, PNG are the extension for file. So friends, these are the extension. GIF, you should know, JPG and PNG, these are the extension for image data. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question, that is RTE Act, Right to Education Act. So this is an important question, was implemented in India with effect from. So it was implemented in India from the 1st May 2010. So this, according to this act, the government has made the primary education mandatory in India. So this was implemented, or this has come, this act has come in effect from the 1st May 2010. Now moving to the 21st question. Primary education helps in, so the what are the outcome of primary education? So I will see all the options. Socialization of child, yes it happens. Democratization of child, it happens in course of understanding. So it also helps in understanding. Now, so the correct answer as usual is all of the above. The primary education helps all the three options which are given. Now moving with the 22nd questions, a child may have hearing impairment if he speaks loudly unusually. So friend, generally those who are hearing impaired, they generally talk in the louder voice. He comes nearer to the speaker during conversation. So this is also one of the symptoms or the one of the characteristic. He generally says please repeat to the teacher. So this is also one thing. And now, so the correct answer is all of the above to find out the hearing impairment in the child. Now moving on to the 23rd question. A good teacher is one who, so friends, for being a good teacher, she should inspire students to learn. So the correct answer for correct characteristic for the teacher is she should inspire students to learn. So this is the characteristic of the good teacher. Now moving on to the next question. Teachers uses visual aids to make learning. So friends, teacher uses visual aids. So obviously it is it will make it simple, but if you have audio visual aids, so what happens, it becomes interesting. So so the correct answer for this is it becomes interesting. Now moving on to 25th question. What is the most effective way to reform the aggressive behavior of child? So the options I will read, and then after that we can come to the answer. He should be punished severely. So as I told, in teaching aptitude, as a teacher you cannot be a harsh, you cannot take the last approach or the last available option to you, that is harsh punishment. And B, he should be ignored. So this also cannot be done. As a teacher, you should reform your student. He should be kept in isolation. So this will not solve the problem. So reason for the behavior should be investigated. So this is the correct answer. The reason for this behavior should be investigated. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, what are the factors related to learner that affect the learning? So friends, the factors affecting the learning are, so we will read, a physical mental health of the learner. So this is obviously one factor. Level of aspiration and achievement, motivation, this is also an option. Readiness and willpower. So friends, all of these are the options which affect the learning. So the correct answer is all of these. Now moving on to the 27th question. The education provided to the child by the school is, so friends, the school education is a formal education. So it comes under the formal education. Read about the formal, informal and traditional education. One question like it comes every time in the examination. Moving on to the 28th question. The best method of checking students' homework is, so the best method of teaching checking students' homework is to check by teacher himself in regular way, because the student, they themselves will not be able to assess the homework. So it is better to check by teacher himself in a regular way. So this is the answer. Now moving on to the 29th question. Dash dash is the considered a sign of motivated teaching. So the options are maximum attendance in the class, remedial work given by the teacher, questioning by the student. So this is the correct answer, friends. So questioning by the student is considered as a motivated teaching. Now moving on to the 30th question. Narmada Bachao Andolan is an example of. So friends, if Narmada Bachao Andolan comes, or you heard it, it is about the social worker Medha Patkar. So generally it will come to your mind that it is about women's movement. So it is not women's movement, it is about environment. So so the correct answer for Narmada Bachao Andolan is, it is an environmental movement. So remember this, it is an environmental movement. Now moving on to the 31st question. It is, parents should play a dash dash role in the learning process of young children. So options is negative. So it is ruled out, because no parent will play negative role in the learning process. Option C is sympathetic. So that also won't work. Sympathetic role will also not help to overall growth of the child, and neutral way also will not help. So here the correct answer is proactive. They should be proactive in the learning process of their young children. Now moving on to the 32nd question, which is Kritika, who does not talk much at home, talks lot at school. It shows that. Now option A is, they have given us one statement. Now the we have to draw some conclusion. The school provides opportunity to children to talk a lot, so that cannot be an option. Teachers demand that children should talk a lot at school, so this also cannot be an option. She does not like her home at all, so that cannot be the answer. Now her thoughts are acknowledged at school. So friend, this is the answer, because whenever you are you get acknowledged, you will speak up, and if you are suppressed, you will not talk very often, because you will be made fun of, then nobody would like to talk. Now the correct answer is, her thoughts gets acknowledged at school. So friend, 33rd question is, World Environment Day celebrated on. So this is from People and Environment. This question is from People and Environment section. And so friend, we should know the important day for at least one or say 2 days from every 10 topics of this syllabus. So at least we should know at least 30 to 40 days related to the topics from the environment or from the syllabus. So the correct answer for the World Environment Day is 5th June. On 5th June, the World Environmental Day is celebrated.
And the next question is, a part of large quantity of fly ash produced in the thermal power plant is used for. Option A is soil conditioner, B making bricks, C road making, D burning. So friends, as you know that A soil conditioner also it has been used, and road making also it has been used, and D burning also it has been used. But the part of a major part is been used for the making bricks. So our option is making bricks. So moving on, which of the following gases is largely responsible for global warming? Option A is sulfur dioxide, option B is carbon dioxide, option C is chlorine, option D is ammonia. So friends, if you have read about the greenhouse gases which are responsible for global warming, so they are ozone, water vapor, methane and carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide is the main component, and option A, sulfur dioxide, C, chlorine and ammonia are not the major contributor to the global warming. So you please read the greenhouse gases, you will understand that. So option here is B, carbon dioxide, which is a major greenhouse gas. So friends, moving on to our next question, which of the following is not non-conventional energy source? Option A is solar, option B is tidal, option C is geothermal, option D is coal. So friends, the non-conventional energy sources, you can easily answer this question, that as we know that solar, wind that is tidal, wind, tidal, geothermal are the non-conventional energy sources, and the conventional energy sources is coal, petroleum and other type of thing. So this atomic thing are non-conventional sources. So option here is D, coal. Next question, the selection of teaching aid depends largely on the age of student. Obviously it is depends on the age of student, interest of student. Yes, it also depends on the interest of student, and age and motivation of the student. Yes, it depends on the age and motivation of the student. And option D is educational level and age of the student. So friends, here this selection of teaching aid, it depends on educational level and age of the student. Why? Because see, age of the student is same, it is given in the three options A, C, D, but the education level also is important. If you are using the same ad which you are using for the class 1 and the class 12, so that won't help. So in this case you have to use, see, motivation of the student, there is no relation with teaching ad for that. So the option D, educational level and age of the student, is the correct here. Now moving on to our next question, friends. The question is, the main objective of teaching is to facilitate learning, option A. B, option B is to give information about unknown facts. Option C is to use teaching aid to simplify content. Option D is to form good learning habits in student. So friends, the main objective of teaching, like if you see all the options, you feel ki okay, all options can be the option, but we have to use the most probable and most possible answers. So to give information about unknown facts, see these things, this cannot be the objective of the teaching. So option B ruled out here. C, to use teaching aids to simplify the content. Yeah, this is good, but this cannot be the objective of the teaching. See, teaching aids helps in teaching, but that should not be the objective. Now we have come across option A and D. So to form good learning habits in student, yeah, that also is an objective, but to facilitate learning, to make learning easier for the student, should be the teaching main objective of the teaching. So the answer here is to facilitate learning. So friends, these were our 5 MCQs for today. I will be uploading more such episode based on your response. Please like. So the first question is, the dash dash of research article is placed near its beginning. So friends, options are A, summary, B, abstract, C, synopsis, D, preface. So friends, here you see they have asked us what is at the beginning of the research article. So friends, here if you see option A, B, C, D, the option D is eliminated because preface is written at the beginning of the book, not a research article. So you eliminate the option B. Now coming to the option C, synopsis. So synopsis is not something you write in the research article. It is a short or brief summary which you write of the article or of the works. So it is not part of article. Okay, now these two things, A and B, these two are the part of the articles. So friends, the article start with the abstract, then introduction, then result and discussion, and finally it ends with summary, acknowledgement and references. So friends, this is the order: abstract, introduction, result and discussion, then summary, acknowledgement and references. So option here is abstract B. So friends, I hope you have understood this. Now next question: research journal with a high dash dash are commonly considered to be more important than those with lower ones. Now the four options here are: the eigen factor, H index, impact factor, I-10 score. So friends, now if you look at four options, you will understand what is it. Now I'll tell you, the H index, option B, and I-10 score are not about the impact of the journal, research journals. They are about the individual scientist, or about, as you know, I-10 is it is used for Google Scholar, and H index is a citation index for a scientist. So these two have ruled out. Now we have competition between A, eigen factor, and C, impact factor. So friend, these two are very similar to each other, but the only difference is in eigen factor, it changes when the size of journal changes. Like if you have more article, it will be different for smaller journals, and it will be different for the bigger journals. So the perfect match for this should be the impact factor. Impact factor, it is based on the citation of the journal. So citation is the criteria. If impact factor is high, the journal is considered more like it is a valuable journal. Impact factor is less, it is not that good journal. Now moving on to our so the answer here is C, impact factor. Friends, have idea of all these terms. Now the next question: A dash dash is a short term intensive course for small group emphasizing problem solving and learning newer technique. So friends, option A is workshop, B is seminar, C is summer school, and D is refresher course. So friends, refresher schools and summer course, summer school are eliminated here because summer school is only for summer vacation, and it is not meant for the newer technique or problem solving, this thing, emphasis on problem solving. And refreshers course also eliminated. Now we have workshop and B seminar. So seminar is it, the above statement suits to seminar, but seminar is used in broader terms, like it has other activities also. If you see the workshop, it is a part of seminar only, but it is specific to the problem solving and learning newer techniques. So option here is A, workshop. Now moving to the next question of ours here. What is Prasar Bharati? Now this is related to communication thing. It is a private company owning TV channels, a telecom company owning a large mobile network, and advertising and public relation wing of central government, an autonomous body for public radio and TV broadcasting. So as we know that Prasar Bharati is somewhere related to government of India, but it is not a private company. So option A is eliminated. And telecom company owning a large mobile network, no, it is not. It is it is not a telecom company, so it is a broadcaster only. So option C and D we have here. So it is advertising and public relation wing of central government. No, this is not the option. So it is, the option here is the autonomous body of public radio and TV broadcasting. So D is the option. Remember this thing, friends. Now the next question, the HTTP, the full form in the context of internet. They have asked us what is the full form of HTTP. Friends, please remember full form of HTTP, www. So this World Wide Web is the full form of www. So HTTP is four options: higher text transmission process, higher technical textual platform, hyper text transfer protocol, and hyper transmission of truncated procedure. So option as I have written here is hyper text transfer protocol. Please remember I told you www, World Wide Web, and HTTP. So this is it, friends.
So the question is, which of the following is the correct chronology of internet based facilities? So they have given option A, Google, Hotmail, Facebook, and WhatsApp. Friends, you should know that, because see, in teaching this Google, Hotmail, and Facebook and WhatsApp, now these social media and search engines have become very popular for any knowledge giving or whatever. So the friends know that when Google was founded, Google was founded in 1998 by Sergey Brin and co-founder. Hotmail was founded in 1996 by Indian origin Sabir Bhatia, and Facebook was founded, somewhere around 2005, I believe, I don't remember the exact, but, and WhatsApp was founded in 2009. So friends, from this information you can easily say the option C, that as Hotmail 1996, Google 1998, Facebook 2005 or 4, I don't remember that, and the WhatsApp was founded at 2009. So the option here is option C. So friends, moving on to the next question. Identify the odd element from the following on the basis of its basic function. So friends, here if you see Windows, Android, MS Office, Linux, and Unix.
Today is National Assessment and Accreditation Council, that is NAC, was established in. So friends, generally there will be one or two questions based on this year of establishment. So the options are 1964, 1966, 1994, and 1996. So the correct answer for this question is 1994. I hope you have answered it correctly. So the NAC was established in 1994. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, Indira Gandhi National Open University was established by an act of parliament in the year of. So friends, the Indira Gandhi National Open University, that is IGNU, was established. So the options are 1991, 1993, 1990, 1985. So the correct answer for this question is 1985.
The IGNO was established in 1985. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Which is the satellite channel launched by IGNO on 26th of January 2003 for the growth and development of distance education? Technical distance education. So friends, mark this word, technical distance education. So for technical distance education, the options are Rajashri channel, Eklavya channel, C Gyan Darshan channel, and D none of the above. So friends, generally we'll go for Gyan Darshan channel because which is very famous. But for technical distance education, the IGNO has launched Eklavya channel. It is in association with various IITs and in between IGNO. So the correct answer for this question is Eklavya channel. I hope you have answered this correctly. This was a bit tricky, but remember, for technical distance education, the Eklavya channel is the correct answer. Moving on to the next question, which is, which of the following article of the Constitution of India safeguards the rights of minorities to establish and run educational institution of their own liking? So friends, they have asked us the article which provides the safeguard to the minorities to establish and run the educational institution. The correct answer, I'll tell later. First, I will say options. Option A is Article 30. Option B is Article 31. Option C is Article 32. Option D is Article 33. So friends, the correct answer is Article 30. So it provides the minority and authority to establish and run an educational institution of their own liking. I hope you have answered this correctly. This is very important question. Most of the time questions will be asked in different manner, but remember the Article 30 is the correct answer. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, National Education Day is celebrated on. So friends, National Education Day is celebrated on the day when Teachers Day is celebrated. But the options, as I'll read, is 5th January, 5th February, and 5th August, and 5th September. So the correct answer, as I told earlier, is 5th of September. So National Education Day is celebrated alongside the Teachers Day. And now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Friends, this mock test is little bit hard. I hope you don't get discouraged, because in exam also there is a chance that you will have a hard paper. But as you move to the till 50th question, you will find that it was average. Like, you try all the questions and you will find that you have scored a good marks. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following organizations look after the quality of technical and management education in India? So is, options are A, MCI, B, CSIR, B, C, NCTE, D, AICTE. So the MCI is Medical Council of India, looks after medical education. CSIR, as we know, is looks after the scientific research. And the correct answer for this question is, for quality of technical and management education, it is looked after by AICTE. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following university has adopted the meta university concept? So friend, this is a new concept, that is meta university, where HRD ministry has, they are trying to test this concept. Meta university, where you don't have to bound to the particular curriculum. Like, it is a mix of credit system, where you can have courses from liberal arts and courses from the sciences. This concept is implemented by, the options are Delhi University, Assam University, Hyderabad University, and Pondicherry University. So DU, that is Delhi University, has adopted this meta university concept. And in future, we will see the majority of the universities adopting it according to HRD ministry. I hope you have answered this meta university question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following institutions are empowered to confer or to grant degrees under the UGC Act of 1956? So the options are, the university established by an act of legislature, an university established by an act of parliament, that is Central University, an institution which is deemed to be university, that is a deemed university. So all of the above is the correct answer to this question. I hope you have answered it correctly, because all the state universities, central university and the private university are empowered to confer degree to the students. So moving on to the next question. Next question is, the next question is, the first Indian satellite for serving the educational sector is, option A is Satedu, option B is INSAT B, option C is EduSat, option D is INSAT C. So the correct answer is EduSat, that is option C. It is also called GSAT 3 and it is launched exclusively for the serving the educational sector of the India. And the correct answer, as I said, is EduSat. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following statements are correct about this central university? The options are, the president of India acts as a visitor of the university. This statement is correct. The central university is established by under an act of parliament. So this is also correct. And if it is act of legislature, that is a state university. And C, president has the power to nominate some members of the executive committee or the board of management of the university. So this is also correct. So it turns out that the correct answer for this 10th question is all of the above. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following statements are correct about the distance education in India? So first we'll see the statement. The first statement is, it supplements the formal education. So this statement is correct. Now it reduces the cost of education. So friend, this is also correct, because when distance education is there, you can have a lot of means to study, like as we have discussed earlier, that IGNU channel is there, Iglova channel is there, people can watch those channels and they can study. So it reduces the actual cost of infrastructure and having lot of teachers. Now it replaces the formal education. So this cannot be true, because it can't replace the formal education. So formal education, it has no replacement. Now it enhances the access to education. Yes, it do enhances the access to education, because people sitting at home or people doing job, they can also study or enroll to the course and study on the weekdays and weekends and the holidays. So the barring option C, all options are there. So here if you see, the correct answer is C, that is A, B and D. So the correct answer is C. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this. So friends, where you have multiple statements, all you need to do is read them carefully and try to eliminate one. If you can eliminate one, obviously, like, there are a very high chance that you will be able to answer that question correctly. Moving on to the next question, which is the 12th question, is, put the following units of storage into the correct order, starting from the smallest unit and going to the largest. So friends, they have given the memory sizes. I'll read all the memory sizes which they have given. Is first is A, kilobyte, B, byte, C, megabyte, D, terabyte, E, gigabyte, and F is bit. So bit is the smallest unit of the all the given. So if you see in the options A, B, C, D, all you have F as the first. So that is okay. Now the last biggest among these, so you know that generally we use mobile memory, so MB is less than the GB, so gigabyte, and the terabyte is more than the gigabyte. So last should be D. So if you see the options here, the correct answer, F should be the smallest and D should be the highest. So the correct answer is C. So it is accordingly. I hope you have answered this question correctly. All you need to do is read it properly, and if you remember at least 2-3, you can arrange them and you will be able to answer this question. Moving on to the next question. Given the following email fields, which of the email addresses will Swami be able to see when he receives the message? So what happens here, the Swami has received a mail, but he has received the mail via BCC, that is black carbon copy. So friends, remember, when you are you send blank carbon copy, then sender, or sorry, that receiver will not be visible to the others. So in this case, Swami is receiving the mail, but she will be able to see the others here. Whom he can see is the main receiver, then the carbon copy receiver, and he will not also be able to see the blank copy receiver. So Swami cannot see Rama at test.com. So this he cannot see. Apart from that, he can see the Ram at test.com, Raj at test.com, and Ravi at test.com. I hope you understood this. If there is any problem, you can comment in the comment section. So the correct answer is B. As I said, when blank carbon copy you send, it is invisible, even if you are also one of the blank carbon copy receiver. So I hope you understood this. The correct answer is B. Moving on to the next question, which is, which of the following is considered as a major source of pollution in rivers of India? So friends, options are unregulated small scale industry, B, untreated sewage, C, agricultural runoff, D, thermal power plant. So the correct answer for this, the major source of pollution in rivers of India, is untreated sewage. So I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question, which is, deemed university declared by UGC under the section 3 of UGC Act 1956 are not permitted to. So friends, they have asked that deemed university are not permitted to what? The first is to give appellation to any institute of higher education. This is permitted. Offer programs in higher education and issue degree. As we have seen, they can issue degree. Offer distance education programs without approval of the distance education council. So this, they can offer the distance education program, but they cannot open the off campus and offshore campus anywhere in the country and overseas respectively without the permission of UGC. So the correct answer is D. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is email. So friends, this is an easy question, but if you don't know, then it will be difficult. So it stands for A stands for electronic mail, B stores and stores purchase orders and invoice between the computers, C both A and B, and D none of the above. So the correct answer for this question is, it stands for electronic mail. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Hardware is a physical component of computer. It includes processors, memory chips, input output devices, tapes, disk, cables, modems. So friends, it includes both A and B. So the correct answer is both option C, it includes both A and B. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, the input devices are the option A is physical components of computer hardware that accepts data and instructions from the user. So this is one option. Communication between hardware and hardware components that results in the transfer of data. So this is USB, friends, and for option C, both A and B and none of the above. So the correct answer is first, that is A, physical component of the computer hardware that accepts data and instruction from the user. So this is input device. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, 1 byte is A 8 bit, B 18 bit, C 10 24 bit, and D 30 bit. So friends, remember this memory convergence, because at least one question or related questions will be asked in the teaching aptitude paper in the section information and communication technology. Now the correct answer for 1 byte, it is 8 bit. 1 byte is equal to 8 bit. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question, which is, 1 kilobyte is equal to, option A is 8 byte, option B is 18 byte, option C is 10 24 bytes, and option D is 30 byte. Now the correct answer for this question is 1024 byte. So 1 kilobyte is equal to 1024 byte. Remember friends. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this correctly. Next question is, the much discussed Tehri Dam project is located in which of the following state? So friends, remember, Tehri Dam project is located in the Uttaranchal state. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this correctly. The term regur refers to, so friends, these questions are from the people and environment section. The regur refers to option is laterite soils, black cotton soils, option C is red soil, option D is deltaic alluvial soil. So the correct answer for the term regur is, it is black cotton soil. Okay friends, I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, major objective of education is, so friends, the major objective of education is, option A is reforming the society, option B is making student disciplined, C is developing inherent abilities and powers of students and making students followers of the teacher. So the correct answer for this question is developing inherent abilities and powers of students. So it is to reform their inherent abilities and powers. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question, which is, now friends, this next 4-5 questions will be on the institutes of national importance and their location. I hope you are aware of their locations. If not, you'll learn it with these questions. Now the first question, or sorry, the 24th question is, National Defense Academy is situated at, so friends, the options are Khadakwasla, Pune, B, Dehradun, C, Allahabad, D, Chennai. So the correct answer for NDA is situated in Khadakwasla, Pune. Moving on to the next question, Indian Institute of Advanced Studies is located in, so friends, the options are A, Shimla, B, Solon, C, Dharmashala, D, Chandigarh. So the correct answer is Shimla. Indian Institute of Advanced Studies is located in Shimla. I hope you know this, or you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question, Indian School of Mine is situated at, so the options are A, Patna, B, Dhanbad, C, Kolkata, and D, Guwahati. So friends, the correct answer for the Indian School of Mines is located at Dhanbad in Jharkhand. Now moving on to the next question, Indian Institute of Sciences. So this is topmost institute. If you see any of the ranking, it is the topmost institute recognized in the India and international arena. So the correct answer for IISc, generally if you know that IISc Bangalore, so people like, it is called IISc Bangalore, so it is located in Bangalore. Now moving on to the next question, Indian Institute of Foreign Trade is situated in, so the options are Lucknow, Dehradun, New Delhi, and Mumbai. So the correct answer for this is New Delhi. Indian Institute of Foreign Trade is situated in New Delhi. So friends, remember all those institutes and their locations. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, National Institute of Immunology is situated in, so friends, the correct answer for this question is, it is situated in Delhi. National Institute of Immunology is situated in Delhi. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, Bhabha Atomic Research Center, that is BARC, is located in, so friends, if you know, the BARC is located in Mumbai, and if you I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question, which is, Central Forensic Science Laboratory is located in, so friends, it is located in Chandigarh. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now the location of the important central institution, this question ends here. Now we'll move on to the next question. Most students in the medieval universities learned by, option A is laboratory experimentation, B, reading the Bible, C, listening to lectures, and studying in library. So friends, in medieval era, students learned by listening to the lectures. So this is the correct answer. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Who said that members of the same species are not alike? Options are Darwin, option B is Herbert Spencer, option C is Bell, option D is Einstein. So friends, if you recall the Darwin's theory of revolution or evolution, it has mentioned that the members of the same species are not alike, and the correct answer for this question is the Darwin. So he said that members of the same species are not alike. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, the process not needed in experimental research is, option is A, observation, B, controlling, C, manipulation and replication, and D, reference collection. So friends, in experimental research, the least required thing is reference collection. So the correct answer is reference collection, because in experimental section you can rely on your own data because it is reproduced by you yourself, so you don't actually look for the references in that cases. So the correct answer is reference collection. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, teacher encounters various problems during his professional experience. He should, so option is A, resign from his post in such a situation. Do, option B is do research on that problem and find solution. C is avoid a problematic situation, and take help from the head of the institution. So the correct answer is do research on that problem and find a solution. That's what make a good teacher. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this correctly. Validity of research can be improved by, option is A, eliminating extraneous factors, B, taking a true representative sample of the population. So friends, these two are the correct. So the correct answer for this question is validity of research can be improved by both of the above statement, that is A and B. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question is, instructional ads are used by teacher to, option A is glorify the class, option B is attract the students, option C is clarify the concept, and option D is ensure discipline. So the correct answer for this question is instructional ads are used by teacher to clarify the concept. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. So next question is, while writing a research report, a researcher, option A, must not use numerical figure in numbers in the beginning of sentence. So this is correct. And B, must arrange it in logical, topical and chronological order. So this also is correct. Research report should be logical, topical and chronological. Now option C is, must compare his result with those of the other studies. So you should also look at the related references. This also correct. So we are left with the all of the above. So the correct answer is all of the above. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, a research problem is feasible only when, option A, it is researchable. So yeah, this is true. If it is not researchable, then it is not feasible. Now option B is, it is new and adds something to the knowledge. So this is also a requirement. If it is already discovered and everything is done, there is no point of doing research on it. This is also correct. And it has utility and relevance. So this is also correct. Now the correct option is all of these. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question, which is, the validity and reliability of research will be at stake when. So friends, when the validity and reliability of research will be at stake. So they have given the author, they have given the option. Option A is, the author whose source of information is biased and incompetent and or dishonest. So this also a correct. If he is biased, then you cannot trust the finding. Now the option B is, the incident was reported after long period of time from that of its occurrence. So this also is one thing. If it is not properly documented at the time of the happening, then there are chances that you cannot have the good results. The researcher himself is not competent enough to draw logical conclusion. Yeah, this is also correct. Now the correct answer is all of the above. The validity of and reliability of the research data will be at stake when all of these factors are there. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following is the biggest freshwater lake in India? So friends, the correct answer for this is factual question, you should know it, that Ular Lake is the biggest freshwater lake in India. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, the fertility of the soil can be increased by growing. So friends, this is a very common question, like fertility of soils can be improved by legumes. So legumes have they have the properties of binding the atmospheric nitrogen in their root nodules. So you have learned it in the sciences, in the basic primary or secondary education sciences, that they have the root nodules which helps in fixation of the nitrogen. So the correct answer is the legumes, option C. Now moving on to the next question. Krishna Raja Sagar Dam is built across the river. So friends, this is also factual question. It is built across the Kaveri River. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this correctly. Which of the following operating system is used on the Apple mobile phones? So friends, Apple mobile phones, so the options are Windows Vista, B iOS, C Windows XP, and D all of the above. So friends, Apple uses their own operating system, that is iOS. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Next question is, a terabyte is equal to, so friends, as we have seen, the gigabyte is the smallest, the smaller than the terabyte. So 1024 gigabyte is equal to 1 terabyte. As I already told you, I have to memorize all these relation between the different memory unit. I hope you have answered this. The terabyte is equal to 1024 gigabyte. Now moving on to the next question, which is, which of the following statement is not correct about university grant commission? So we have to find the false statement. So the statements are, A, it was established in 1956 by Act of Parliament, so this is correct. It is tasked with promoting and coordinating higher education, this is also correct. So it receives plan and non-plan funds from the central government, so this is a wrong statement. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Which one of the following is different from the other members? So friends, if you look at the four options, A is Google, B is Bing, C is UC browser. So these three are search engines, different search engines, and Mac is an operating system. So I hope the odd member from this is Mac, which is operating system. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question, which is, research is based upon. So friends, research is based upon, option A is scientific method, option B is scientist, option C is experiments, option D is general principle. So the friends, research is based upon the scientific method. So if you follow the scientific method, then only there will be a research. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Research should be, so it should have objective, option A, option B is valid, it should be reliable. Now friends, these all three should be there in the research. So the correct answer is all of the above. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the last question of this mock test, that is, research is always is about exploring new knowledge. Yeah, this is true. Option B is verifying the old knowledge, this also is true. And filling the gap between the knowledges, gap between the knowledges is, you know one thing, the other thing is known, but the in between there is some vacancy, so or some gap, so that gap can be filled via research. And as all these three statements are correct, the correct answer is all of the above. So friends, this was it. I hope this test was good, you scored good. And if you have liked it, please share and subscribe to Global Online University, and please recommend to your friend. And I'll be uploading the next mock test sooner in the coming days. For that you have to subscribe. Thank you for watching.
The question is, government agency responsible for collection of various types of data in India is CSO. So friends, CSO stands for, the options are, A, Central Statistical Organization, B, Central Statistics Office, and Central Staff Organization, D, Central Staff Office. So friends, CSO, as you know, that many data they release, like the very recently released employment data, the full form of the CSO is B, Central Statistics Office. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. The question is, NPTEL project funded by MHRD stands for. So friends, the NPTEL is a joint initiative between MHRD and IITs, where you will have the online lecture by IIT faculties available on the online platform, and everybody in India can watch them.
So the full form for NPTEL is, the correct answer is National Program on Technology Enhanced Learning. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. The question is, find out the next term in the following series. So friends, I have also included the mathematical reasoning questions in this mock test. So you'll have more such questions. Now coming to this question, where the number series is 0, 3, 8, 15, 24. So this is a simple question to begin with. If you just take out the differences between the adjacent number, so it is in the 0 and 3 it is 3, and from 3 to 8 it is 5, and from 8 to 15 it is 7, and from 15 to 24 it is 9. Now the next number difference should be 11, so if you add 11 to 24 it will be a 35. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is from the environmental section. Which plant is used in biodiesel? So friends, if you have studied or if you know, then only you will be able to answer this question. And the correct answer for this question is jatropha. So jatropha is used for the biodiesel making. Now moving on to the next question. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Next question is, which of the following will not come under natural hazard? So friends, this is a simple question. If you are able to answer, if you read the question carefully, which of the following does not come under the natural hazard? So if you see, flood is a natural hazard, volcanic eruption is a natural hazard, earthquake is natural hazard, and as you know, the plane crash, it can be a technical or it can be a human error or it can be anything, but it won't come under the natural hazard. So the correct answer here is plane crash. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the full form of NEET, an examination for admission into medical courses in India? So friends, generally like this is very common term, but many of us don't know the exact full form of the NEET. Now the options are National Employment Cum Entrance Test, the National Eligibility and Exam Test, the National Entrance and Eligibility Test. Option D is the National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test. So friends, the correct answer for the long form of the NEET is National Eligibility Cum Entrance Test. So remember this, though this is very common, but generally we are not aware of it. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, lead tetraethyl is added to gasoline to make. So friends, this is also from the environmental section, and options are to make gasoline thin, to increase its speed, to decrease the fumes. So friends, the correct answer is it is added to gasoline because of its anti-knock property. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, Ray Tomlinson introduced this symbol. So friends, this is important personality in the field of information and communication technology, where he has introduced the symbol at the rate. He is a computer programmer, died recently in 2016, and he introduced this symbol at the rate. Generally we use it for email and giving the various type of addresses. So I hope you have answered this correctly. So at the rate symbol was introduced by Ray Tomlinson. So you may be asked who introduced this symbol, other way, like they may also ask you the name of the programmer. So remember this name and the symbol, Ray Tomlinson has introduced the at the rate symbol. Now moving on to the next question. Which of the following is unique numeric identifier used to specify particular host computer? Now friends, they have asked you the numeric identifier. So friends, as you know, any particular on the host on network can be identified with IP address. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, HTML stands for. So friends, HTML, the options are hypertext makeup language, hypertext marketing language, and hypertext marked language, and D is hypertext markup language. So the correct answer for this question is hypertext markup language, that is option D. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, the content of communication is called. The options are A, message, B. Noise. C. Channel. D. Distortion. So friends, correct answer for this question is the content of communication is called message. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, who is better teacher? Options are the one who strictly follows the disciplinary guidelines, the one who devotes full time to school, and the one who is interested in overall development of his students. And option D is one who develops quality leadership in students. So friends, the correct answer for this question is the one who is interested in overall development of the students. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. The next question is, students who keeps on asking questions in the class, he should be advised to meet teachers personally. Option B, should be encouraged to participate in classroom discussion. Option C, should be encouraged for self-learning. Option D, should be encouraged for continue questioning. So friends, here correct answer is should be encouraged for continue questioning, because questioning while learning is a good habit, and it will like if you stop that habit, then it will be like killing the curiosity of the student. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, identify the unethical practice of the researchers from the following. So these questions are from research aptitude. So the unethical practice is, see, options are avoiding plagiarism. So you should avoid plagiarism. This is ethical practice. B, avoiding duplication. This is also a ethical practice. You should avoid duplication. And avoiding manipulation. Option D is also an ethical practice. You should avoid manipulation. So the unethical practice here is avoiding the reliable data. Avoiding the reliable information is an unethical practice. So friends, I hope you have answered this correctly. The answer is C, avoiding reliable information is an unethical practice. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, effective learning means. So options are modification in behaviors of learner, B, consistency in behavior of learner, C, to recall information by the learner, and C, D, is good performance of the learner in the examination. So friends, the correct answer for this question is modification in the behavior of the learner. So the effective learning means modification in the behavior of the learner. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, basic purpose of the communication is. So friends, if you have studied, is the basic purpose, there are five purposes of the basic purposes of the communication, and the main purpose of the communication is to inform, to pass the message. So the correct answer is option A, to inform. The basic purpose of the communication is to inform. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, person who transmits a message is called. So friends, this question is from the communication section. So so the options are A, receiver, B, sender, C, decoder, D, barrier. So the correct answer, the person who transmit a message is called sender. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is required while reading? So options are A, ability to comprehend, B, reasons for reading, C, help in reading, and D, time for reading. So friends, these all the options looks correct, but the correct and the most most probable answer for this question is ability to comprehend. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, one number in the following number series is wrong. Find out that number. So friends, if you this is a question from the number series, and if you look at these numbers, like if you try to subtract, or if you try to add, or if you try to do multiplication, you will not be able to get the correct answer. If you try, if you know the squares of the numbers, then you will understand that the 196 is the square of 14, and 169 is of 13, 144 is of 12, and 121 is of 11. But 101 is not a square of 10. So it should have been 100 in this series. So the correct answer here is 101. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is the 1 terabyte is equal to. So friends, I have covered lot of questions regarding this memory conversion, so you should be able to answer this. Options are 8 GB, B 18 GB, C 10 24 GB, and D 30 GB. So 1 terabyte is equal to 1024 GB, 1024 GB. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question.
Next question is, pointing towards a person, a man said to a woman, "His mother is the only daughter of your father." So friends, how is this woman related to that person? I suggest you read this question carefully and try to answer. The options are daughter, B sister, C mother, and D wife. So for this question, this type of question, you need to have practice. So the correct answer for this question is mother. The woman is mother of the said person. I hope you have answered this correctly. If not, you can practice, and if you still have a doubt, you can ask in the comment section. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, Konkani is related to Goa. In the same context, Dogri is related to. Options are, so friends, Konkani is a language, or is a language spoken by the region from the Goa and the Konkan region. And in the same way, Dogri is a language, and it is spoken in which region? So options are A, Andhra Pradesh, B, Maharashtra, C, Himachal Pradesh, and D, Assam. So friends, correct answer for this question is, it is spoken in Himachal Pradesh region. So Dogri is a language spoken in Jammu Kashmir, some part of Punjab, and the part of Himachal Pradesh. So remember this. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is web browser? So friends, if you see the options, the option A is Windows. So Windows is a operating system. Linux is the operating system. iOS is the operating system for Apple. And the correct answer for this question is option C, that is Google Chrome. It is a web browser. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, Rousseau advocated an educational method which consisted of removing the child from. So if you know the biography of Rousseau, you'll be able to understand this. So Rousseau advocated an educational method which consisted of removing the child from option A, school, option B, burden, option C, past memory, option D, society. So correct answer for this question is Rousseau. When it comes to Rousseau, you remember burden. So he advocated removing the burden from the educational method which consisted of removing the child from the burden. Now moving on to the next question. All who have meditated on the art of governing mankind have been convinced that the fate of empires depend on the education of youth. So this statement, like whose this statement is, so options are A, Aristotle, Socrates, Plato, and John Locke. So the correct answer, this statement is made by the Aristotle. So I hope you have guessed it correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, communication by using the eyes is an example of. So options are A, non-verbal communication, B, written communication, C, verbal communication, D, none of the above. Friends, the communication by using eye, or by hand gestures, or by other means, it is non-verbal communication. So it comes under the non-verbal communication. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, in a group discussion, we should be. So friends, options are, so A, assertive, B, dominating, C, subjective, and D, ignorant. So D can be easily ignored here, because one can't be ignorant while discussing. So the correct answer is, you should be confident and you should put your point with confidence. So the correct answer is assertive. In a group discussion, we should be assertive. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is,
in one-way communication. A message are passed without. So in one-way communication, message are passed without A, receiver, B, channel, C, treatment, and D, feedback. So friends, in one-way communication, one doesn't care about the feedback or the responses from the receiver. So correct answer here is the feedback. So when there is no feedback, it is one-way communication. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is about the number series. And in this series, so here friends, it is 3, 11, 23, 39 and 59. So what will be the next number? So friend, if you subtract 11 from 3, it will be 8 from the first. And if you subtract 23 from 11, it will be 12. And if you subtract 39 from 23, it will be 16. So it is from the 8, 12. So the difference is coming 8, 12, 16, then 24. So that way, if you finally, if you come across, the correct answer will be 73. If you add 24 to 59, it will be 73. I hope you have answered this correctly. And in this question, if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment. You can just write the question number. And if there is any doubt, you can or if there is any query, you can or any suggestion, you can bring to my notice. Okay, moving on to the next question. Next question is, in an effective communication, there is no need of. So friends, in an effective communication, option A is modulation in voice and speech, B, adequate gestures, mastery over the content. So these top three are important for effective communication. So handsome personality, like there is no need of handsome personality for the effective communication. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of these is important in having mutual understanding with your colleagues? So friends, options are A, effective listening, B, speaking, C, talking, and D, writing. So friends, listening to others, that way if you are not listening to anyone, then there will be no understanding. So the correct answer for this question, for having a mutual understanding with your colleague, you should be a good listener or effective listener, or you should listen to the people. So the correct answer is effective listening. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, in a group discussion, one must communicate with. So friends, one cannot communicate with hostility, that my point is only valid, or I'm only the correct person. B, ignorance, we have also discussed in the earlier question, it is also ruled out. And long sentences, so you should, it should also be eliminated, because you should put your point in precise manner in shortest possible sentences. Now the correct answer here is, in group discussion, one must communicate with knowledge. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, full form of BOD. So this question is from people and environment section. So friends, BOD is a I hope you know this. I'll read the options, and maybe meanwhile you can get your answer. Biodegradable oxygen demand, biological oxygen demand, biochemical oxygen demand, and bandwidth on demand. So the correct answer for this question is biochemical oxygen demand. So read, this is very important topic in terms in with respect to environment, biochemical oxygen demand. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Which of the following is appropriate definition of a computer? So friends, they have asked us the appropriate definition of the computer. So a computer is a machine that can process information. So that this is correct, but it is not a precise definition. Now moving on to the next question is, computer is an electronic device that can store, retrieve, and process both qualitative and quantitative data quickly and accurately. So this looks the correct definition, but we'll see other options and then come back. Computer is an electronic device that can store, retrieve, and quickly process only quantitative data. So this is wrong. Computer, option D is, computer is machine that can store, retrieve,
and process quickly and accurately only qualitative data. So C and D is eliminated, and in from option A and B, B looks the correct answer because it is precise definition. Now I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which one of the following is not a source of data? Options are A, administrative records, B, population census, C, GIS, and D, sample survey. So friends, if you look at option A, administrative records are source of data, population census also give us data, and sample survey gives the data. But geographic information system is not a source of data, it is a framework of gathering, managing, and processing the data. So correct answer is here is GIS. So GIS is not a source of a data. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. The question is, which of the following comprises of teaching skill? So first is A, blackboard writing, B, questioning, C, explaining, and D, all of the above. If you look at the options, so all of these, blackboard writing, questioning, and explaining, comes under the teaching skills. So here the correct answer is all of the above. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which is numbers system used to store data and for the calculation in the computer? So this is from the ICT, Information and Communication Technology, and the options are A, decimal system, B, hexadecimal system, C, octal system, and D, binary system. So question is, which number system is used for storing data and calculation in the computer? So friends, the correct answer is, it is a binary number system. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is pointing device? So friends, pointing device is a directing device, means it appears on your computer, like your the cursor, your mouse. And same applies. Now the we'll see the option. Option A is hard disk. It is not a pointing device, it is storage device. CD-ROM drive also is a storage device, and RAM also is not a pointing device. So the correct answer is touch screen used for the computer input. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, computer memory consists of. So it is RAM, ROM, C, PROM. So the correct answer here is all these three are the computer memory. I hope you have answered this correctly. So the correct answer is all of the above. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, no computer can do anything without. So they have asked very basic question. So minimum requirement for computer functioning is, say option is A, program, B, memory, C, chip, and D, output device. So friends, the main thing that that is required for computer to do anything is a program, computer program. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. In comparison to internal, that is main memory, disk memory is. So friends, this is a very important question. I hope you know this disk memory. It is a slower and less expensive. So it is slower, but it is less expensive. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question, which is, a monitor looks like a TV set, but it does not. So friends, if you look at laptop or say any desktop monitor, it has. So options are, look wise they are same, but what is the difference? A, receive TV signals. They do not receive TV signal. They do not give clear picture. So they both give good picture. If you have good laptop, laptop, it will give good picture. Give steady picture. They both give steady picture, and both can display graphics. So the only difference is they cannot receive the TV signal. Laptop screen or say desktop screen, they don't receive the TV signal. So that is the difference. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. So next question is, when sending an email, the dashed line describes the content of the message. So it is a title of the message, or you can say the subject
line. You know, subject, you write whatever the main content. So that is the describe the content of the message. So correct answer is subject. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is dash is collection of web pages, and dash is the very first page that we see on opening a website. So friends, when you see a like, I will give a general example, like CrickBuzz or say CrickInfo, when it is a website. So it is, but if you look at the different web pages, there will be like a live score, there will be some articles, so different web pages will be there. So what is where here? So website is a collection of different web pages. So now you understood the web pages, and the when you click on the CrickBuzz in or any CrickInfo, I'm just giving a general example of the website. If you click, you what you see is a home page. So it is the first page, and once from home page you can go to the different pages. So the correct answer here is website and home page. Please if you you are not clear with this, you can check it on Google. Like, you can open any website and you see you what you go is on the home page, and then if you click on the other pages, that is sub pages, or we call web pages. Now moving on to the next question. LAN speeds are measured in. So friends, if you have these days in India, everybody is using Jio, and you have 2 GB, or based on your plan 1 GB limit, after that your speed. So LAN speed is measured in Mbps, megabits per second. I hope you have wrote it correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is a URL is. So friends, we have discussed different questions regarding URL. You should be able to answer. These options are a computer program, so it is not a computer program. A type of web server, no. It is an address of a document or page on the World Wide Web. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which law protects the crime through internet? So friends, nowadays a lot of crimes are happening on the internet, so the and we also see that cyber security team, cyber team of the different states or different cities are working hard to protect the internet, or to keep the watch on the internet related crime. So the cyber laws protect the crimes, or they look after the crimes through internet. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is ATM stands for. So ATM stands for A, option all time money, B, any time money, C, automated teller machine, and D, arithmetic teller machine. So correct answer for ATM is automated teller machine. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. What is the full form of MOOC? So friends, why I have included this question, because as we have seen earlier, NPTEL is a Indian online learning platform of the top notch IITs and MHRD, and MOOC, it is an international online learning platform from the Harvard and MIT University in collaboration with Microsoft. So the long form for this is massive open online courses. So remember this, what is MOOC? So as I told, it is a online learning platform. It is an initiative of the Harvard, MIT and top notch universities with Microsoft. So remember, there are a lot of online courses which one can watch all around the world for free. So the long form for the MOOC is massive open online courses. Moving on to the last question of the day. World Environment Day is celebrated on. So this is factual question. If you remember this, the correct answer for World Environment Day is 5th June. So it is celebrated on the 5th June to make people or make public aware of the hazards and the protection of the environment. I hope you have answered. This mock test was good for you. You have scored well. If not, you can also keep on watching our mock test. And friends, if you have liked it, please subscribe to our channel Global Online University. Thank you for watching. First question of the day. So the first question is, which is a valid statement among the following? So statements are 1 kilobyte is equal to 10 24 bytes, b 1 mb is equal to 10 24 bytes, 1 kb is equal to 1000 bytes, and d 1 mb is equal to 1000 bytes. So friends, the correct answer for this question is 1 kb is equal to 10 24 bytes. Remember this memory convergence, memory unit convergence. There is sure short question on this question on this topic. Now moving on to the second question. So second question is, the most appropriate purpose of learning is, so the options are A, personal adjustment, B, modification of the behavior, C, social and political awareness, D, preparing oneself for the employment. So friends, the correct answer for this is, most appropriate purpose for learning is modification of the behavior. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is from the number series. So they have asked us to find the one fill in the bracket. So friends, if you look at the number 6000 and 5940, then 5881. Options are, as you can see, so there are options 5746, 5854, 5824 and 5823. So friends, if you look at the every number, so there is definite relation. If you subtract 5940 from 6000, so it will come 60, and if you subtract 5881 from the 5940, so it will be 59. So next number will be less by the 58. So the correct answer is 5823. I hope you have answered this correctly, and if there is any doubt, you can comment in the comment section about this number series or logical reasoning or mathematical reasoning problems. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, find the missing number in the following. So friends, if you see the there is a one definite trend from if you move down from say 147, so it is 27. If you move down the column, then 258, 38. So there is no definite trend, but you 369. So what will be the number? So friends, here if you just see, this is multiplication of the if you look across the column first, 4 multiplied by 7, it will be 28 minus 1 will be 27. And if you look at second column, then 5 into 8, it will be 40 minus 2 will be 38. So likewise, if 6 into 9, it will be 54 minus 3, and the correct answer will be 51. I hope you have answered this correctly. If there is any doubt, you can comment in the comment section. Moving on to the next question. So next question is, in communication, attributing our own thoughts to others is called. So option A is stereotyping, option B is halo effect, option C is projection, option D is barrier. So friends, attributing our own thoughts to others in communication is called projection. So remember this definition. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is the most effective way of the communication? So friends, there are in general there are four ways of communication, but they have asked us the most effective way of the communication. So options are A, non-verbal communication, B, verbal communication, C, silence, and D, written communication. So friends, the correct answer for this is, most effective way of communication is verbal communication. So remember this, this is factual question, and I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is created by Mike Krieger and Kevin Systrom. This app was acquired by Facebook in April 2012. What is it? So friends, as you know that Twitter it operates independently, and LinkedIn is bought by Microsoft. So there are only two options. I also want to tell you that Instagram and WhatsApp are bought by the Facebook. Now they are like, they work as a subsidiary to the Facebook. Now friends, now the correct answer for this, the Mike Krieger and Kevin Systrom founded the Instagram, and then that was acquired by the Facebook in April 2012. So remember this. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. If gold is coded as a home, and come is coded as done, and cord is coded as dose, how would you code sons? So friends, here if you look at gold, and it is coded as home, then it is you can see that O is common, like it is same everywhere. And only thing that has happened that they have used the next letter from the of the earlier letter. So like the, for in first case, in case of gold to home, they have G, in place of G they have used H, and in place of L they have used M, and in place of D they have used E. So likewise, if you do for what they have asked for sons, it will be like, say for S next letter will be T, and as O will be same, so it will be T O. So option A is eliminated here. Now after S O N, if you use next letter of the N, then it will be O. So it will be either it will be B or C, toot or toos. So as the next letter of the S is T, then it will be toot. I hope you have answered it correctly, friends. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is the least desirable outcome in higher education system? So friends, they have asked us the least desirable outcome. So options are A, enhancement of the independent thinking of students; B, increase in students' probing skill; and C, good preparation for the appearing in the examination. Now D, helping the student to think out of box. So friends, the least desirable outcome of the higher education is preparing good preparation for the appearing in the examination. So the higher education is about the enhancement of independent thinking, increasing student probing skill, and helping student to think out of box, and their main motive is not to good preparation of the appearing in the examination. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, as a good classroom communicator, you are supposed to know your... So friends, this is about teaching aptitude section. This is from teaching aptitude section. So for good classroom communicator, you are supposed to know A, audience emotions; B, silent cues; C, artful pauses; and D, counter arguments. So friends, the correct answer for the classroom communicator is you should know the artful pauses. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, olfactory communication refers to... So olfactory, like you might have heard of olfactory gland. Now the correct answer of the options, first I'll read the options and then I'll tell the correct answer. A, communication by smell; B, communication by sound; C, communication by fingers; and D, communication by eyebrows. So the olfactory communication refers to the communication by eyebrows. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, BBC stands for... So friends, so BBC, the options are British Broadcasting Corporation; B, Broadened Broadcasting Corporation; C, Bit by Bit Broadcasting Corporation; and D, none of the above. So friends, the correct answer for the long form of the BBC is British Broadcasting Corporation. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, internal and external factors that affect the message reception by the students in the classroom are referred to as... So friends, the internal and external factor together are that affects the reception by the students in the classroom are referred to as noise. I hope you know this. This is a factual question and I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question is, the academic performance of a student can be improved if parents are encouraged to... Option A is, supervise the work of the students of their ward; option B is, arrange for an extra tuition; option C is, remain unconcerned about it; and option D is, interact with teachers frequently. So friends, only option A and D appears to be like correct, but the correct answer for this question is option A, supervise the work of their ward. So continuous supervision of the and the progress of their work will definitely improve the academic performance of the students. Now moving on to the next question. So next question is, when seven, it is from number series. If they have asked us what will be the next number, so the if you see, the seven is a prime number and the next prime number after seven is 11. So if you apply same logic in for 31, the next prime number would be 37. So I hope, friend, you have answered this correctly. The next question is the study of gestures and body postures for their impact on communication is known as. So friend, this is factual question, and please remember, if you are studying communication chapter for UGC NET and SET examination, remember all the definition. It is factual. Most of the questions like are theoretical, you have to remember them. And for the study of gestures and for body postures for their impact on communication is known as. So the options are kinesics, proxemics, semantics and informal channels. So the correct answer is the whenever the gesture communication through gesture, it comes under kinesics. So friends, I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, when a sender manipulates information in order or so that in order to that it will be seen more favorably by the receiver in communication, in this case it is called. I hope you have understood the question. It is question is when sender manipulates the information as to be seen more favorably. So the what options are: A, selective perception; B, linguistic trap; C, filtering; and emotional, and D, emotional appeal. The correct answer for this question is filtering. When sender manipulates the information in order to be seen more favorably by receiver, then it is called filtering. I hope you have answered it correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, a primary education in the mother tongue has been safeguarded in the article. So friends, remember all the articles related to the education, and this is also an important question, where primary education in the mother tongue is safeguarded in under which article. So the options are A, article 29, option B is article 350, option C is article 220, and option D is 351. So the correct answer for the safeguarding of primary education in mother tongue is 350, article 350. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is a process of communication? So friends, there are processes of communication: A, downward process of communication; B, upward process of communication; and C, lateral process of communication. So all these three are processes of communication. I hope you have answered this question correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, name the philosopher who proposed the technique of questioning. So friends, remember the most of the philosophers from the medieval era. So the technique of questioning was proposed by, if you know, is proposed by the Socrates. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the full form of CAI? So it is in terms of computer and related thing. So the correct, I hope you know the answer. I'll read the options: computer assisted instruction; B, computer assisted information; C, computer associated instruction; D, computer associated information. So friends, the correct answer for the long form or full form of the CAI is computer assisted instruction. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is not considered as a plagiarism? So friends, first we'll read the options and then see: make use of work of another and misrepresented it as your own. So this will be considered as a plagiarism. One should not copy. This is like a copy, so copying is plagiarism. Now drawing a content from work of another without acknowledging the source. So friends, when you are taking some content from some any source, whether it is journal or whether it is any article, so you should acknowledge it. So this is also eliminated. Now paraphrasing too closely to original text. So this also is plagiarism, because you are just changing the word and keeping the meaning same. So this also comes under plagiarism. Now option D is drawing content from another work and adapting it with due acknowledgement. So friends, this is not considered as a plagiarism, because you are acknowledging it And when you are acknowledging it, this won't be considered as a plagiarism. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, which was the first English newspaper published in India? So friends, it was published in 1780 and it is Bengal Gazette. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, bibliography refers to. So friends, I'll read the options. A true story written about someone. So this is not bibliography. The correct answer for this 24th question, bibliography is a list of sources used in the report and where they can be found. So their address. So this is called bibliography. List of sources and their address. So remember this. Now moving on to the next. Next question is from the communication section. The question is, our dress code is an example of dash dash communication. So friends, our dress code is an example of, options are A, verbal, B, non-verbal, C, written, D, spoken. So the correct answer is non-verbal. Our dress code is an example of non-verbal communication. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, computer cannot boot if it does not have the. So the options are A, compiler, B, loader, C, operating system, D, assembler. So friends, a computer cannot boot if it does not have operating system. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. So the next question is, human being are referred to as Homo sapiens, which is a device which is called silico sapiens. So friends, who are called silico sapiens? So the options are A, computer, B, hardware, C, robot, and D, drone. So spelling of drone is wrong here, so it is drone, D, drone. Now the correct answer for silico sapien is computer. So the computers are called silico sapiens. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which is India's first bullet train project? So they have asked the two destinations between which this project will be launched. So the option is A, Mumbai to Ahmedabad, B, Delhi to Chandigarh, C, Delhi to Jaipur, D, Chennai to Kolkata. So friends, the correct answer for the first bullet train project is Mumbai Ahmedabad. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, Supreme Court of India has ordered the transition of vehicle to which Bharat stage? So BS stands for Bharat stage level. Now friends, this decision will be implemented from the 1st of April. So not decision, this is a suggestion from Supreme Court. So the correct answer is Bharat stage 6. So this is correct answer. I hope you know this and you have answered this correctly. If you don't know, please note this down, that Supreme Court has advocated for the Bharat stage 6 engines. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, in which state the first children's university was established in India? So friends, the options are A, Gujarat, B, Maharashtra, C, Karnataka, and D, Madhya Pradesh. Now so friends, the first children's university was established in Gujarat. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which Indian astrophysicist and Nobel laureate predicted rapidly rotating stars emitting polarized light? So friends, the correct answer for this is S. Chandrasekhar. So Professor Chandrasekhar predicted that the rapidly rotating stars emits the polarized light. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the full form of NIRF? So these days friends, there is a lot of talk about NIRF, a methodology to rank higher education institute in India. So friends, the options are A, National Institute of Research Framework, B, National and International Ranking Framework, C, National Institutional Ranking Framework, and D, National Institute of Research Funding. So friends, the correct answer is National Institutional Ranking Framework. So NIRF is called National
Institutional Ranking Framework. I hope you have answered this correctly. Remember this because this is important and current topic. Moving on to the next question. Swayam is a portal initiated by. So friends, options are A. Niti Aayog, B. MHRD, C. Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, and D. Ministry of Railways. So friends, the Swayam portal, an education portal, is opened by the MHRD. Next question is, it has been usually opined that learning in educational institute these days is wasted because A. Subjects are boring, teachers communicate their subject thoroughly, C. Subjects are not communicated in life relevant ways, and most teachers are well acquainted with their subjects. So friends, these days learning is wasted, it is said, because these subjects are not communicated in a life relevant ways. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, for good learning, it is a must for the school to have. So option A is vast open area, B. Good library, C. Big playground, D. Good students room. So correct answer for this question is good library. So good library is must for a school for learning. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, what would you do to inculcate the feeling of cooperation in students? So friends, to improve the feeling of cooperation in students, options are A. Give them good reading material on cooperation, B. Show pictures and movies on cooperation, D. Organize a class on cooperation. So friends, the correct answer is put them to group work. So the group work will inculcate the feeling of cooperation among the students. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, which of the following is the most important purpose of carrying out research in education? So friends, options are A. To improve the status of institution, B. To improve the chances of promotion, C. For individuals' personal growth, and for increasing the social prestige. So friends, the correct answer for this question is for individuals' personal growth. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is, what is the hypothesis? So friends, options are A. Tentative statements that need a validity test. So this is hypothesis. B. A factual statement. C. Past experience based supposition. D. All of the above. The correct answer for this question is a tentative statement that needs a validity test. What does MICR? So friends, we often come across this term in internet banking world. So the MICR stands for, the options are magnetic information cable recognition, B. Magnetic insurance cases recognition, C. Magnetic intelligence character recognition, D. Magnetic information cable recognition. So the correct answer is magnetic intelligence character recognition. Friends, I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Insert the missing number in the following sequence. The sequence is 511-95191. So friends, if you look at this, from 5 to 11 they have added 6, from 11 to 23 they have added 12. So if you add double of the 12, that is 24 to 23, the correct answer will be 47. And if you add 48 to 47, then it will be 95 and so on. So I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is, impact factor in a research is linked to. So the correct answer for impact factor, friends, options are A. Published books, B. Research journal, C. Research paper, D. Research thesis. So the correct answer is research journal. Impact factor is about research journal. So impact factor, if higher the impact factor, it is good for journal, it is more impact journal, and nowadays high impact journals are in more demand amongst the researcher. Now moving on to the next question. Maulana Abul Kalam Azad's birthday is celebrated as A. National Education Day, B. Teachers Day,
C, National Higher Education Day, and D, National Education Policy Day. So the correct answer is National Education Day. It is on 11th November. Remember this, friend. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is NAC, that is National Accreditation and National Assessment and Accreditation Council. Accreditation of the university reveals. What does it reveals? NAC accreditation, what does it reveals? So friends, the NAC accreditation reveals the merit of the university. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is regularity in class attendance can be ensured by. So A, organizing cultural program in the college. B, imposing the fine from students. C, having frequent interaction from the parent and students. And D, having strict discipline code in the college. So the correct answer is having frequent interaction from parent and students. I hope you have answered this correctly. Moving on to the next question. Next question is purpose of using teaching aid in classroom is A, to motivate student for learning. B, concretize abstract concept. C, simplify teaching. And D, use imagination of the students. So friends, the first purpose or the important purpose of the teaching aid is to simplify teaching. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is radio and TV are more powerful and successful in communicating socially relevant message because. So friends, they are designed for such purposes. They are capable of catching the attention of the people. They present a variety of program and they can reach even illiterate masses. So friends, that is the option D is the correct answer. So because see, if you take an example of newspaper, only literate person can read it, but the in case of TV and radio, the even illiterate person also can be targeted. Now moving on to the next question. Next question is full form of PDF, which is generally used. So the options are A, portable document format. B, portable document file. C, permanent document format. D, permanent document file. Now friends, the correct answer for PDF is portable document format. Next question is the process of filtering the message from the source to receive is called. So options are A, handout. B, degeneration. C, gatekeeping. And D, Kinney 6. So we have seen the D is eliminated because we have seen it is gestures and body postures. So the correct answer for filtering message from the source is gatekeeping. The next question is the CBFC, Central Board of Film Certification, certificate of you for means. Now friends, the option is under exhibition, unknown exhibition, universal exhibition, unrestricted exhibition. So friends, the correct answer for the CBFC U certificate means it is unrestricted exhibition. I hope you have answered this correctly. Now moving on to the last question of the day. So last question is Doordarshan was delinked from All India Radio in the year. So the options are A, 1976, B, 1970, C, 1983, D, 1980. So friends, the Doordarshan was delinked from All India Radio in the year 1976. So friends, this was it for today. I hope you have liked this. If you have liked it, please share, subscribe to Global Online University and also spread the message that Global Online University is doing good job. Thank you. Thank you for watching, share and subscribe.